guys, welcome back to my channel. On today's video, I'm going to do a tutorial on this eye look. I'm not sure if it can be called a cut crease, but that's what I'm going to call it. For this look, I only used the Lorac Pro palette, and I hope you enjoy this tutorial. To set my eyeshadow primer, I'm going to go into the shade Cream, and I'm going to place that all over where I put the eyeshadow primer. For my transition shades, I'm going to mix the shades Taupe and Mauve. And I'm going to apply those right above the crease. For my crease shade, I'm going to use the shade Espresso. And I am going in with a dark color right away, and it is going to look intimidating at first. But we're gonna clean it up with some concealer, and at the end it's going to look really good, really well blended and clean. So don't be intimidated by using a really dark shade as your first shade in the crease. And as you can tell, I'm going to put that from the inner to all the way to the outer corner of my eye. And I'm just going back and forth windshield wiper motions because I want to make sure this color is very well blended. It is a darker color, so I don't want any patchiness, and I want to make sure it's all nice and smooth and well blended. I'm going to go back into the brush I used for my transition shades, and I'm going to mix the transition shades with my crease. I am not going to add any more shadow to the brush. This is just to blend more. I'm going to grab some of my Better Skin concealer. I'm going to place it on the back of my hand, and I'm going to grab it with a flat brush. This time, to create the cut crease effect, I am going to place the concealer from the inner corner of my eye all the way down to the outer corner of my eye. And again, I'm going to want to follow the shape of my eye. So I'm basically going to be placing the brush on the socket of my eye, or at least that's what I think it's called. I didn't pass anatomy. And just follow the shape to create that outline. Now, I don't worry about the outer corner being as sharp as the inner corner, because in the outer corner I am going to be blending in the dark black eyeshadow, so I'm just going to leave it as it is now. And I'm going to go back into the shade Cream, and I'm going to grab it with that same big fluffy brush, and I'm going to set the concealer. This way I'll prevent creasing, and it will help my eyeshadows last a little bit longer. And with my finger, I'm going to grab this beautiful gold shade, and I'm going to apply that all over where I applied that concealer. To clean that up, I'm going to go back in with my same crease brush, and I'm going to blend everything together. Right now, I am not adding any more product to the actual crease brush. I'm just going to use whatever is left over in the brush. For my outer corner, I'm going to go into the shade Black, and I'm going to grab a smaller, more precise brush and apply some black eyeshadow and try to blend that in. Again, I'm going to move upwards so I don't bring any of the darkness low. I'm also going to bring some of that black color into the crease just to darken it up a little bit more. For my lower lash line, I am first going to use the shade Espresso, and I am going to apply that very, very close to my lash line. I'm only going to apply that to the outer half of my lower lash line. I don't want to close off my eye by putting it all over the lash line. Just the last half of it. To blend out that dark shade, I'm going to go back into Mauve and Taupe, and I'm going to apply those right under Espresso, and I am going to bring them down a little bit lower. I'm also going to keep those in the last outer half of my lash line. I'm going to go into the shade Gold, and I'm going to apply this to the middle. And I'm going to bring it in closer to the inner corner of my eye, but I am going to blend it out. So you'll see that I'm going to start here, hopefully you can see. And I'm going to just swipe it back and forth, but I'm going to try to concentrate it in the middle. And now I'm going to dip into my Wet n Wild highlight, and I'm going to place that in the inner corner and the very end of my lower lash line that's closer to the inner corner. So at the end, the plan is to have my lower lash line kind of have an ombre effect that goes from the rose gold of the highlight to all the way to the dark chocolatey brown colors I put at the end. I'm going to use that same Wet n Wild highlighter as my inner corner and my brow bone highlight. I don't want my brow bone highlight to be as powerful, so I'm going to take a big fluffy brush and I'm just going to blend everything together. And this is going to help take some of the highlight off. And it's gonna help blend the crease shades with the transition shades and make everything look much smoother. To tight line, I am going to use the Essence pencil in the shade Black Fever, and on my waterline, I'm going to use the Wet n Wild crayon in the shade Calling Your Buff. And for mascaras, I'm going to first apply the Benefit Roller Lash Mascara to add length. You can hear my dog jumping all over the place, she just wants attention. And to add volume, I'm going in with my Lash Paradise mascara, and I am going to do this all off camera. I had to go off camera to tend to my dogs, but like I said, I did my liners and my mascara off of camera. I mixed the roller lash with the Lash Paradise, and this one adds good length and this one adds good volume, and so far I think they work well together, and I really enjoy the way my lashes look right now. For lips, I used ColourPop's Frickin' Frack, and for eyebrows, like I always do, I use my Anastasia Brow Definer and their Clear Brow Gel. That is it for this video, you guys. Thank you for watching. I think my camera's dying. But please let me know if you enjoy these one palette only tutorials, or do you want me to do tutorials that include more than one palette and random single shadows. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video.